I welcome you all to Anthony TV. For those of you who haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so by smashing the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell.
The world's largest man-made dam, Kariba. The largest transboundary river in southern Africa, the Zambezi, is home to the dam, which was constructed on the river between 1955 and 1959 and completed in 1960. Across eight nations, the Zambezi River Basin is the fourth biggest in Africa. Among the largest man-made constructions ever, dams are used to cross rivers or estuaries or store water in lakes. Some of the biggest examples have been built using several million tons of rock, concrete, soil, and other materials. In addition to producing hydroelectric power and storing water for farming and human use, dams also defend against peak floodwater flow and make recreational and navigation on waterways easier. Determining the world's biggest dams is difficult since the term largest might refer to a structure's height, volume, the size of the reservoir it impounds, or the amount of electricity it can produce. It is believed that the Kariba Dam is the biggest in the world based on its reservoir capacity or water storage capacity. The dam, which is situated in the old Kariba, Kariba Gorge, forms Lake Kariba, which has a surface area of 580 square kilometers and a water storage capacity of 185 billion cubic meters. At its broadest point, the Lake Kariba is 32 kilometers wide and 280 kilometers long. The Zambezi River Authority owns the double-curved concrete arch dam, which was built by Italian company Impresa between 1955 and 1959. The purpose of the dam is to prevent flooding that occurs once every 10,000 years. The dam was built with 1.036 million cubic meters of concrete, measuring 128 meters in height and 617 meters in length. It was constructed by a group of Italians that included Impresa Giuseppe Torno e Company, Impresa Italiana All'Estero, Impresa Lodigiani, and Impresa Umberto Girola, with their own power plants on the north and south banks of the dam. Respectively, Zambia and Zimbabwe have the potential to generate 1,050 megawatts and 1,080 megawatts. But due to low lake levels, their respective producing capacities have been lowered to fewer than 400 megawatts. In southern Africa, climate change has resulted in higher temperatures and less precipitation, yet, regular operations have undermined the bedrock upon which the dam was built, making frequent maintenance of the dam critically necessary and boosting the possibility of a dam collapse.